Hey, how's it going? This is Robin Williams from therealrobinwilliams.com. Welcome to this video. In this video, I'm just going to go over really quick, kind of like my weekly strategy for getting ready for the week, right? So basically, just a time where I just literally sit down and I plan out my content for my week. One of the things I just want to let you know in advance is that, you know, I work full time, and if you're somebody who you don't have a lot of time during the week, you definitely want to cut out a lot of the BS. You want to cut out a lot of the extra that you don't need to do. You know, some people are marketing on like 8 different social media accounts at the same time, and your focus is spread thin. So one of the things you want to do is kind of look at your schedule and make sure you're not doing anything extra that you don't need to be doing. Make sure you're not spreading yourself thin to where your efforts aren't really making a difference across, you know, 8 different social media sites. So one of the things I focus on is basically YouTube videos. I'm putting up blogs, not really for SEO, but basically just having a way that people can go to my blog site and get that information. I can email that blog site to my list. And then obviously I just do some Facebook. So that is pretty much my focus realm. So depending on what you're doing, your schedule may just like what you put on your schedule, and I'll show you what I use here in a second. But what you put on your schedule is going to be, you know, dictated by what all you do in your business. So just know that the plan that I'm going to show you is something that you can take it and make it your own. Put your own stuff on there. Another thing is, I remember looking at different people who showed me their plans, their schedules, and it was really, really awesome. Just make sure it's something you want to use. So I like it simple. I have a spreadsheet. Some people use something like Trello. I think Trello is good if you have an assistant. Right now, I don't. So right now, I think going to Trello, writing notes, doing all that stuff is a lot more work than doing something like on an Excel spreadsheet. But however, your business is ran, like however you run your business, however you upload your content and all that other stuff, just make sure you know that you can do it on your own. You don't have to copy this verbatim. You can edit it. In fact, I just edited mine today, so let's go ahead and look at it. One of the first things I like to do is just make sure I just have my Monday through Friday pretty much booked as far as a keyword. So keyword research is one of the things that I do. It doesn't really say keyword research, but that's what I do for this field here. And what I like to do that first. I like to do it on the weekends. If I find myself doing it through the week, I know that my time that it's going to take for me to get everything done is literally, I want to say it's uncertain, because you don't know how long it's going to take you to find something that you want to write about. So I like to keep this on the weekend so that I can literally go and find something and know that if I don't do anything else but find this keyword research, this keyword, come Monday, I know what I'm going to talk about, and then I can do the rest. However, I'll try to squeeze on some of the other stuff here on the weekend as well. But literally, this probably takes up the most time. It's just finding something that resonates with me that I can talk about and that has a decent, how can I say this? Has a decent chance for me being competitive on YouTube. So that's my primary one, like I said. So the next thing I'll go and do is I'll write an outline. I don't know if, connection loss. Lost connection on my mouse. There we go. I don't know if you ever struggled with shooting video. I have like no outline for this video, so it's a little rough for me to actually be shooting this video. But one of the things that I love to do for my videos that helps me tremendously is write an outline. And I like to pick like 3 little miniature subjects to put on my outline, so that I can know exactly what it is I'm going to talk about. So I could talk about, for instance, how to market your small business online. So there is a ton of ways you can market your business online. Am I going to talk about how to market your business online on Facebook, or am I going to talk about how to market your business online on Twitter, or am I just going to do like something more general? So having an outline really helps organize my mind. So I'm not stumbling over words. You pretty much know what you're going to talk about. Literally, because I do editing for my video, I can chunk it down and I could chunk it down in threes and actually stop to see what my next paragraph or my next subject or sub-subject is going to be about that video, and that way I can edit it out in my video. So I love the outline. I feel like it just helps you flow on your video. Obviously, the next thing I'm going to do is shoot my video. All that is I have my camera, or I'm doing it from my computer. I'm literally shooting my video. I'll probably have my outline in front of me, depending on what it is I'm talking about. And I'll just go from there. The next thing I might want to do is shoot some photos for my video. So, or for my video and blog post. So basically, we know with branding in this industry and network marketing and stuff like that, you want to basically put your face out there, right? You want to put your face out there. I don't know, that sounds crazy, but you want to make sure that people know that this is your blog, you own this content, you know, this is your YouTube channel, whatever it may be. I think putting your face out there on your content can really help display a sense of authority. It can help people relate to you. You know, just seeing your face out there just helps tremendously. So just shooting a couple videos with my camera, so that I'll have it available for my blog card. I call it a blog card, really my blog photo and video photo. And then if I want to post it on Facebook, I can even have something on for Facebook. Pexel is just something that is a step. It's just an extra step that I like to do. One of the things I do for my blog is I kind of upload a background photo for my header. And what irritates me, I literally just added this today, the photo and the pixels. But what actually irritates me is when I'm in the flow of writing my content and doing all that good stuff, I actually have to stop and go find a photo that looks relatable to the content that I'm doing. So what I did actually today is put that in my prep, right, my prep work. So basically, if I do my keyword research, I did my outline, and I'm shooting my video, if I still have time during the weekend, I'll do photos and I'll look for the photo for my blog. However, even if I'm getting ready to sit down on a Monday or a Tuesday and I haven't done that yet, I can choose to do that before and just go down and look for my photos for the blog and stuff like that. So, like I said, you can make this as simple as possible and according to what you have to do. You may not have to do that. You may have somebody doing this for you. So, editing my video, I sit down, I go and edit my videos. Thumbnail is something similar to, the thumbnails and the blog cards. That's what I use my photos from. Basically, like I said, I'm very busy. So I have a template. So it really doesn't take me that long to create a thumbnail and a blog card. Like literally, I could probably create a thumbnail, a blog card for the whole week in maybe 5 to 10 minutes. So it doesn't take long at all. Then obviously I could upload my video to YouTube. I just have it on there as a step. Write my video description. So write my video description and write my blog is, you know, the two top things I have to do as far as writing, you know, like putting that, you know, putting the words to paper or whatever, or words to the blog, I guess. If it's something that I can get away with, most of the time I'm doing this the day of, because it's a lot, right? To do five videos, the outline, shoot a video, edit a video. You know, do the blog content, video description, all that stuff. To do that all in a weekend is pretty much a lot, unless you literally don't want to have a life at all. So a lot of times I'm doing that the day of, but at least it's on my checklist that I need to do it. You can email it to your list, and then you can also create a Facebook post. So literally, as I'm going, I could just check it off with an X, right? I can say, okay, X, I've created my outline X, I shot a video, and it's so simple. I don't know if you watch other videos like Trello and stuff like that. It's just so much just to say I've completed this, right? If you know exactly what you're going to be doing, if you are good with just sitting down and getting the work done, you know what needs to be done, then you know something as simple like an Excel spreadsheet should be good. But if you probably have, you know, three people, you know, or you and somebody else with their hands in the pot, Trello will be a lot better because y'all be able to coordinate there without holding up a document. Like two people can't edit this Excel document at the same time saying that they completed something. But like I said, depending on your needs, it's all going to be up to you. I definitely highly recommend that you sit down and prepare something, whether it be Excel, Trello, a Word document, you know, notebook and paper if you like that. Definitely prepare for your week so that you can be more organized. Clear, and I find that when I do prepare for my week, I am more likely to make sure all of those steps get done. So that's all I have. This is Robin Williams from TheRealRobinWilliams.com. If you're looking to pretty much surround yourself with people who are, you know, I don't want to say like-minded because we are always, what is like-minded, right? Like, I don't know what your mind is. You don't know what my mind is. But if you're looking for people who are interested in building a business, interested in helping you, doing a mastermind, learning and growing from each other, definitely click on a link at the top of the description of this video. If I'm on YouTube or if I'm on Facebook, just inbox me. And I will introduce you to a system that has actually helped me build a business online. And I'm actually excited because a lot of this stuff that I'm doing here that I'm showing you, the efforts are really going towards my YouTube. Yeah, blog, right? But I don't blog for SEO. I blog to put my content out there for people to, you know, get to know me and go through my blog and stuff like that. But I'm actually excited because we're, you know, going hard on this YouTube and we're getting together and masterminding and looking at other people's success and creating their first funnels online and the first blog sites online and stuff like that is pretty exciting. So if you're interested in looking at that, just click on the link at the top of the description of this video, and I'll see you on the inside. Peace.